Hello, welcome to my channel, Wing Spiritual Clarity. My name is Wendy Wing. I'm doing a daily psychic tarot reading, tuning into the day's energies, asking if there are any messages, any news we can use, what do we need to know for whoever is tuning in. Monkey, ingenuity. The situation calls for adaptability and innovation. So how many times this week, if you are a regular watcher, apparently looking at things from a different point of view. New energies, new you, new perspectives, new ways of looking at issues or obstacles, finding new ways to overcome and work through. Wow. All right. So this is a general reading. So take what resonates and leave the rest. In the past, we've got the energy of the four of swords in reverse. Coming out of healing. Ooh, I've got two. Feel like someone refusing to heal and someone who's coming out of healing in past energies. Let's see which one. Wow. Okay. Interesting. I'm still on two storylines. So someone who refused to heal in the past, refused to see things from another point of view, refused to heal wounds. That person in the past felt very disconnected. Alone, abandoned, maybe disconnected from spirit. That's a very intense type of feeling of separation. This is someone in desperation in the past, refusing to heal. And if all our answers are within us, that we have everything that we need within us, all the answers, and someone refuses to heal and tune into that, then they create more and more separation from their own answers. This feels like a recipe. So such a recipe for disaster. I was saying that and pulling this card, Ten of Swords. Yeah. So this is someone terrified of the healing process. Healing, if you hurt yourself, which you have a cut on your hand. Really cleaning it out and just leaving it alone so it will heal itself. That type of wound will heal itself. Most of the time, the largest amount of pain is when the wound was inflicted and healing isn't that painful. This type of wounding, an emotional wounding, it takes a lot of bravery to look at the pain, to feel the pain, to acknowledge, to accept. And this person, the way they dealt with their wounds was refusing to heal and separating themselves. If you look at this person, it's like they've got their hands over their ears, like, la, 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 I'm not going to listen. No, it would be too painful to look at things from a different point of view. So it's almost like this person is refusing to see, hear, or connect with light, their light. And so it's creating that feeling of abandonment and woundedness, which led them to being, they were punishing themselves. I don't think they realized that they were self-sabotaging, refusing to go where their answers are. And that all that woundedness, holding that in, the charge of it, someone who's just walking around with so much pain, unresolved, unhealed pain, and refusing to heal from it. They're a walking wound maker. Their wounds create more, you know, hurt people. And that's what I'm getting here. Feels like a lot of people who don't know how to heal properly. They don't understand their wounds, and so they disconnect. And this is unconsciously an act of self-sabotage, and then they start sabotaging others. They have so much of that sabotaging, destructive, wounded energy, and they're trying to heal themselves of the charge, not by going within and accepting, but by flinging it and projecting it onto others. It looks like in the past, they were given an opportunity to see the truth. Feels like several opportunities to see the truth, but they, it's again, there's like spirit keeps coming in and saying, it's time to acknowledge the truth. It's time to see this from a different perspective. This person, I feel like they just refuse. It's like, I'm just gonna, at some point in my life, the way this, my strategies worked for me. And it's like, yeah, but they're not working for you now. You need to adapt. Ingenuity. And this person refuses to innovate. This person is just like, at some point, these strategies and tactics wounding others worked, and I got my way, but they're not working anymore. In current energies, death and rebirth. End of a cycle. And beginning of a new cycle. Death of a cycle, beginning of a new cycle. It feels like you are ending cycles and having a new beginning. You are moving towards something you're very passionate about, something you're very excited about, taking a lot of action. It's happening fast. I feel like feels like things were stuck for a long time, but now things are moving quickly. That's why Monkey is here to say it's time to adapt and innovate. You are moving towards your Ten of Cups. You are moving towards creating happiness, joy, emotional fulfillment, not just for yourself, but this feels like group on a large scale. You're gathering momentum too. It's interesting. I got this very beautiful mix of divine masculine and divine feminine energy. I'm getting that divine feminine energies are learning how to speak their minds, speak the truth, speak their truth, be very direct, letting go of a need to please. Well, there's some type of I feel one thing also that's shifting for the divine feminine in this current energy is feels like in the past people have believed that feminine energy is weak, like synonymous, that it's, yes, divine feminine energies can tap into a lot of subtle energies, but subtle energies are not weak and to be ignored. There's some type of balance coming back. Balance around misunderstanding around divine feminine energies. Wow. Okay, and those who have purposely had Ten of Swords type of behavior towards divine feminine energies. If you are a divine feminine energy who had people purposely try to block your progress, feels like someone in the past was given the opportunity, they're very unconscious and wounded, carrying around trauma wounds. And they just refuse to wake up, which is A-okay. Everybody's on their own schedule. However, as they refuse to wake up, they kind of double down on patterns of behavior and beliefs that are toxic for our lives, that no longer create success in the energies. And it looks like what's coming out in the environment currently is people are seeing what was done in the dark. It's coming clear. It's coming aware somehow. What this person or the people in this type of energy, what they try to do to block, you know, they're hurt. And so they're trying to project blame. Feels like power plays. They enjoy creating, they have so much suffering and pain here that they projected outside of them to give them temporary relief. So they constantly have to do that to unload the pain and see it expressed somewhere else. And instead, it's like an infection every, you know, until someone knows how to not pass that pain along and heal themselves. That's what it feels like you've been doing, is transmuting pain and wounds and growing and maturing and evolving and expanding. And there are those who are not. And so it feels like you're also needing to adapt and innovate as you continue on your path towards growth and evolution, and allowing space for others, like healthy boundaries, but also space for, because at some point you were probably wounded, wounding others and refusing a call and doubling down. And if someone, how could someone reach you? Definitely by not engaging and, you know, head to head with you. And I don't feel like anybody could have convinced you, tried to evangelize and tell you, you know, I don't know if it's necessarily, this feels like a case by case thing. Some people, you know, leave them alone. Don't try to, this isn't the type of shift where we all go out and evangelize and we need everybody to think and see things like we do. That is group think. What we're moving towards is each of us individually finding our answers within, trusting that you find the right people at the right time, synchronicities, timing, divine timing. Speaking of, Three of Cups in the center of your reading, your higher self is in the energy of companionship, friendship, coming together, unity, belongingness. This is a great time as you start releasing more and more people, situations, thoughts of old energy and old activities, then you just start replacing them with people who are a better match. People who are doing the work. I do feel that if this is part of your storyline, that something's coming out in the environment about how toxic and cruel someone was. If that's coming out, people are seeing that, then I feel like the people who are friends already know about this, but in the larger environment, it feels like people will be shocked by what this person did. And they'll see this person a whole different light. I feel like they're shocked. They don't know what to, I mean, I feel like what's interesting is they come to you like, what, well, why didn't you tell us? And you're like, I think that if you would have broadcasted what this person did, whatever that is personally in your story, if you would have in the past when this was happening said this is happening, people would have, I don't know, just like discarded it. Or I think because it would have come from you and they painted you in some type of picture or something, but the way this is coming out is not by this person. It's coming out reluctantly in the, and so people are seeing who this person or people, who they really are, how they really move. And because it didn't come from you, because you've just focused on healing and moved on, then people realize that it feels more truthful because it's coming out in the environment and not from you. Feel like a group, like, oh my gosh, heartache. You've been, oh wow, Three of Cups clarified by Three of Cups. You will, however, this coming out, you will see people who, I feel like you're going to be celebrated. A lot of love. You're getting very clear about who, who's, what level, what tier of friendship and closeness you allow people next to you. I think what's, you are open to a lot of new friendships, a lot of new loving connections. Something is ended. I feel like this is the last chapter. Oh, this reminds me, this feeling. What is that movie? Okay, it's the movie Cruel Intentions with Reese Witherspoon. Don't want to spoil it, but if you've seen the movie at the end, this might spoil it because it's the end. After some Cruel Intentions, I think this is a Shakespeare play. Anyway, or an adaptation. So someone being so incredibly cruel and heartless and mean spirited and spiteful, and at the end the song Bittersweet Symphony comes up and the person is exposed, and with just like, oh my god, and that's what this feels like at the end of this cycle, the death and rebirth and current energies. And it feels like the end of Cruel Intentions, that they're unveiled. They thought that they had gotten away with it. And it really doesn't matter to you in as much that you're already walking, you're moving away from this. You're moving towards your happiness. Full Ten of Cups happiness. You are much wiser and stronger than you've ever been, more direct, able, capable. And you're attracting so many people, loving people around you. I don't even feel like part of why I feel like this is coming out, this coming clean, this being seen, is because you have moved on and you're not caring if that's, I feel like you're focused on other things, and the, so it's like, okay, whatever. Your challenge right now is Queen of Wands. I've got two different stories here for this. Let's see which one. Ooh, okay. So I'm getting two different ways to read this. So maybe one resonates more than the other for you. If this is your energy and your challenge, there's some type of sexual, I don't know, like a block. And it feels like it's hard for you to move past it. Feel like your energy might be a little split, like I would love intimacy, sexual intimacy, but I'm adverse to it and not going towards it. So it feels like I want it, but I'm scared. I want it, but so your energy is really split. It's in the challenge position right now because it does feel like there's someone or maybe multiple partners coming in, and this is an opportunity for you to find stability and celebrate that. Just because you've been hurt in the past doesn't mean that you have to close that door and never explore that again. The other way of reading this is that there is there's some type of third party energy, someone who won't stop until they get what they want. So this reminds me of the energy, whoever you were connected with in the past, with that very hurt, wounded energy that wounds others. This person feels like a very good match for that person. So maybe this was a third party, or just someone else connected with this person in the past who refused to heal and hurt others. This is someone really unconscious, and they're trying to get to the energy of Four of Wands, that celebration, that happiness, together, marriage, union. But they're trying to manifest that through pain and suffering and stealing and lying and cheating. And it's just, you can't get there from there. And if it's the challenge is about this third party person, energetically, they got exactly what they put out, you know, what they put out into the universe and what they did to others, maybe you as well, it's came back. But that wasn't their plan. Their plan was to devastate you, devastate others around you, so they can have the success. But instead they got karma. And you got the success. I feel the frustration. That wasn't how it was supposed to go. That wasn't the plan. It wasn't the plan, but it's justice. It's balancing out. It's the truth. If this is your energy, if and around the sexual, being afraid to connect with someone because of past hurts. I think this, use your discernment, but it feels like there's this beautiful opportunity for you and someone else to find some loving healing within a close, intimate connection. But this feels like a divine gift, an opportunity to help you find and bring back that balance. The truth is, you weren't meant to be alone. You've strengthened so much. You've expanded so much, elevated, healed. This opportunity was brought into your environment to help you. You weren't meant to tough it out forever. You were meant to heal from your wounds and traumas, elevate your vibration so you don't repeat the same pattern, so you can have new experiences. So, wow. All right. Those are your messages for today. Let me know if you feel drawn, if you want to share who these people are to you and what the story is. I would love to know that, or anything that you want to share with me. You guys have such amazing insights, and I love how you add on or share your point of view and how you're seeing what I'm reading. So, all right. Thank you so much for allowing me to read your energies. And if you haven't already, like the video, subscribe, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.